your live Super Doppler 4 HD weather forecast.
All right, so we had Tropical Storm Cindy make landfall at about 4 o'clock this morning, as expected, right along the Texas and Louisiana line, and then it moved right along the Texas-Louisiana line northbound all day long, and it continued to weaken to a tropical depression, and that's where it is right now with winds only between 20 and 25 miles per hour sustained. But now it's finally starting to turn a little bit to the north-northeast, and that's what's going to happen. It's going to move northeast later on tonight and then really pick up its forward speed up and through Tennessee and Kentucky and then up into the northeast as we go through the next 3 or 4 days. So the heavier rain in through Louisiana, up here in through parts of Arkansas. The closer you get to the center, very heavy rainfall expected, but it's these rain bands coming out of the Gulf of Mexico, the large circulation around Cindy, which is producing and spawning the tornadoes, and that's what we're going to have to really worry about. So really, right along the track itself, this is where you could have extremely heavy rainfall, even with just the remains, and then watch it. The cold front's going to come in, along with a little dip in the jet stream, and it's going to pick up the remains of the system, move it through Kentucky, West Virginia, and all the way by 2 o'clock in the afternoon over Long Island, the remains. So the heavy rain band will be right about through here. But tomorrow night, it's going to be right about in through here in Kentucky, and we could see some of these rain bands come up and to try to feed this remains of what was Tropical Storm Cindy, and that's where we could see severe weather tomorrow night. Really kind of worried about it, especially if we get some of these individual cells that could possibly produce a tornado, just like we had the one just in Fairfield, just southwest of Birmingham this afternoon. Tornado watches continue for parts of Alabama, Mississippi, and all the way back into eastern part of Louisiana. For us, showers will continue to develop across the area. They're starting to become more widespread back into Georgia. Thunderstorms moving through metro Atlanta now. So this is all going to start to fill in as we go through the night tonight. And then tomorrow, I think we're going to be in a little bit of a lull, which is going to be kind of nice. It's going to be much, much warmer. In fact, it's going to be hot in the upstate outside of the mountains. There's the showers in northeastern Georgia, and then rain showers off and on through western North Carolina all the way through the northern mountains. As far as not a lot of rainfall since midnight last night, 1/14 of an inch of rain for the top honors at the JSP International Airport, only 2/100 of an inch of rain in Greenwood. 79 the high, 10 degrees below the average this time of the year. Didn't feel like it, though, did it? And that's because the tropical air is in place, so it was very, very muggy conditions, so it didn't feel like 79 degrees. It felt like 89 degrees. 72, the high this afternoon, also 11 degrees below the average as far as the high temperature for this time of the year, but it didn't feel like it because it was not a normal 72 degrees, very steamy conditions. Live shot from our camera from up on top of Paris Mountain. There's downtown Greenville there in the background. Mostly cloudy skies outside right now, but very warm, 80 degrees. It's 72 degrees currently in Asheville. So here's Cindy out here that's going through this evening. That batch of thunderstorms that's in Alabama will weaken and move off the northeast. Notice tomorrow morning, we're going to be probably partly cloudy to mostly cloudy skies to start with, and then some sunshine, and it's going to be hotter tomorrow afternoon. While the main focal point will be this front picking up the remains of Cindy, moving quickly through Kentucky and Tennessee. So as this front pushes through, these waves of very strong thunderstorms could march across our area tomorrow night. And in fact, the Storms Prediction Center has a marginal risk for severe weather. Western North Carolina back into North Georgia with the greatest threat farther to the northwest. But I think this will probably gradually make its way into the upstate as we get an update from the Storms Prediction Center during the day tomorrow. And I'll keep you updated on that. Scattered showers and maybe even a thunderstorm. Very humid conditions, very tropical as you can see. And for tomorrow, partly sunny skies in the afternoon, breezy and hot, high 90 in the upstate, a warmer breeze out of the south in the mountains, high temperature 85 degrees. Once we get this cold front to pass by, we dry the air out Sunday and especially next week, lower humidity levels and a little bit cooler temperatures. Not bad for June.